Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Good morning, student. In this session, we are going to discuss remaining subatomic particle discoveries. You know, in my last class, discovery of electrons completed. Now in this session, discovery of proton and discovery of neutrons. So discovery of electron point of view, J.J. Thomson discovered the electron. The name was coined by G.J. Stoney with the help of the discharge tube experiment. Even in the discovery of proton also, protons are discovered by Goldstein. The Goldstein scientist is also discovery of the proton with the help of the discharge tube. It will help of the discharge tube. So in electron point of view and proton point of view, both scientists, J.J. Thomson and Goldstein, both scientists are used discharge tube experiment to discovery of subatomic particle such as electron and proton. Now see here, protons are discovered by the Goldstein. He is used perforated cathode in the discharge tube and repeated J.J. Thomson experiment and observe the formation of anode rates. It means even Goldstein is also, it is used discharge tube experiment. But here in this discharge tube, terminals are changes, electrodes are changes. Now for example, here nana, optimum conditions are similar, 0.001 mm of the Hg and temperature is the 10,000 volts temperature. Now the experiment started in the optimum condition, 10,000 volts and 0.01 mm pressure. What happened here? Some rays start from anode to attract towards the cathode. So he concluded, because of this rays are attracted towards the cathode direction, this rays containing positively charged particle. It means, so this anode rays is the stream of the positively charged particle. That's why they are attracted towards the cathode side. So this is the most important point, my dear students. So in the discharge tube experiment of discovery of the electron, the cathode rays is attracted towards the anode direction. But now here, the anode rays attracted towards the cathode direction. But it means the anode rays is a combination of the positively charged particle. That's why they are attracted towards the cathode. So this is the discharge tube experiment. Here only one difference is, anode rays start from the positive terminal attracted towards the cathode. In the discovery of the electron time, cathode rays attracted towards the anode. It means this anode rays, the stream of the protons. Okay, ma? So now see here, this rays is also termed as positively particle and canal rays. Anode rays, another name enna na? canal rays or positively rays. It means all anode rays is the combinations of the positively charged particle. That's why this rays name is, my dear student, positive rays or canal rays. Positive rays are canal rays. And fourth point is, these are simply the positively charged gases ions. So the name of the protons is suggested by Rutherford. The name of the protons are suggested by Rutherford because of the, actually protons are discovered by Goldstein, but after studying the total properties of the anode rays or protons, Mr. Rutherford, Ernest Rutherford only suggested the name of the proton. Ernest Rutherford only suggested the name of the proton. Okay, now see Nana, this is the introduction part of the regarding to the protons. Now properties of anode rays, properties of anode rays. See, almost what are the properties of cathode rays? Anode rays properties also similar, there is no any difference. So anode rays, cathode rays properties almost all similar. Now see here, anode rays traveled in straight line and these are the material particle. So my dear students, like cathode rays, anode rays is always traveled in the straight line in the absence of magnetic field and electrical field. That's why anode rays are commonly known as the material particle, because these rays is always traveled in the straight line in the absence of the magnetic field and electrical field. Okay, next, another important point is, anode rays are positively charged and get deflected by the external magnetic field and affected the photographic plate. So this is also another important point. Actually, like cathode rays, anode rays is also deflected in the electrical field and also magnetic field. In case of the electrical field, the anode rays attracted toward the cathode direction. Because of the anode rays, the stream of the positively particle, na? So that's why in the electrical field, they are attracted towards the cathode direction. And similarly, the anode rays in the magnetic field, they are attracted to north pole direction. Anode rays attracted to north pole direction. So this is the two important basic points regarding to the anode rays. So once again, Nana, anode rays traveled in straight line in the absence of magnetic field and absence of the electrical field. In the presence of magnetic field, they are attracted towards the north pole direction, and in the presence of electrical field, it is attracted towards the cathode direction. It is attracted towards the cathode direction. So see, second point, anode rays are positively charged and get deflected by the external magnetic field and affected by the photographic plate. Actually, anode rays are easily to affected by the photographic plate. That's why it's a existed color behavior in the discharge tube. And after that, third point, Sinana, third point, E by M specific charge. E by M value of this rays is smaller than that of the E by M value of the electron. So generally, electron specific charge is a high comparing to the proton. So that's why here E by M value of this rays is a smaller than that of the E by M value of the electron. Now here the E by M value of the proton is 9.58 into 10 to the power of 7 coulombs per kg. So what is the in case of the electron, what is the electron E by M value? 1.76 into 10 to the power of 11 coulombs per kg. But here 9.58 into 10 to the power of 7 coulombs per kg. This is the two values are very, very important, Nana. Once again, see, Nana, third point, the E by M value, it's nothing but specific charge of the anode rays value almost smaller than that of the E by M value of the electron. So that E by M value of the proton is 9.58 into 10 to the power of 7 coulombs per kg. Next, fourth point is E by M value of anode rays depends upon the nature of the gases. Actually, it's not a fixed number, depending on the gases. Why? Because E by M is nothing but charge by mass. So that's why, my dear students, the E by M value, the specific charge of the proton value, are depending on the nature of the gases. Depends on the nature of the gases. This is the fourth important point. And fifth point is, some of the positively charged particles carry a multiple of the fundamental unit of a electrical charge. See carefully, some of the positively charged particle carry a multiple of the fundamental unit of the electrical charges. So for example, this is the most important properties of the anode rays. See, once again, some of the positively charged particles carry a multiple fundamental unit of electrical charges. Okay, next one. The smallest and lightest positive ion was obtained from the hydrogen atom, that is called proton. Generally, basically, the protons are obtained from the lightest gases. That is nothing but hydrogen. So see here, the smallest and lightest positive ion was obtained from the hydrogen. It is called proton. And seventh important point is, the protons carry positive with unit mass. So the protons are carry unit positive with unit mass. The Rutherford obtained protons by bombarding nitrogen atomic nucleus with alpha particle. So these are the important points. Okay, ma? So see here, how to discovery of the proton basically in the laboratory, Mr. Rutherford. So now see here carefully, Rutherford obtained protons by bombarding nitrogen atom nucleus with alpha particle. Now see here, my dear students, this is a nitrogen. What is atomic number of nitrogen? 7. Mass number 14. So this nitrogen, okay, ma? Now see here, Rutherford, how to discovery of the protons. So now this is the most important experiment. Nitrogen, whenever treated with helium, so this both of them is combined together to form H11. It's nothing but proton, alpha particles of the proton, and additionally oxygen is released. These are the properties of anode rays. Once again, my dear students, anode rays properties almost similar to the cathode rays. These also traveled in the straight line. It's anode rays traveled in a straight line in the absence of magnetic field and electrical field also. But in the magnetic field, it's attracted towards the north pole direction, and electrical field is attracted towards the cathode direction. Because of anode rays are the positively charged particle, that's why it is attracted towards the cathode direction. Okay, na? This is the discovery of the protons, is nothing but anode rays. And last and final subatomic particle is discovery of the neutrons. So it is represented N0. Why it's called N0? Electrons, proton, both of them has charged particle, because electron is a negatively charged particle and protons are positively charged particle, but the neutrons are zero charged particle. There is no any charges. That's why important point is discovery of the neutron. It's N0. So neutrons are discovered by James Chadwick in 1932. Important point, na? Neutrons are discovered by the James Chadwick in 1932. It means up to 1932, only two subatomic particles are only discovered. Number one, electron. number two is the proton. Now, how to did this experiment Mr. James Chadwick? When beryllium or boron nucleides bombarded by alpha particle, neutrons are formed. So this is a important point, Nana. Whenever alpha particles are nothing but helium particle. Helium particle whenever bombarded with beryllium and boron, and chargeless particles are obtained. The chargeless particle's name is the neutron. The chargeless particle name is the neutron. Now see here, important point is they have no charge but possess mass almost equal to the proton. They have no charges but possess mass almost equal to the proton. So this is a discovery of neutron equation. Now this is a beryllium. Atomic mass of beryllium is 9. Atomic number is a 4. So it's bombarded with alpha particle. Alpha particle is nothing but modified helium 4-2. Atomic number 2, atomic mass 4. Apo this both of them is combined together. Now carbon is formed. What is the mass of the carbon? 12, and atomic number is a 6. So 6C12 is formed. Additionally, neutron is released. Additionally, neutron, because of here 9 plus 4 13, the so 13 means 12 already there. So one more mass number is neutron has no charged but it has a mass. It has a mass. So now this is the discovery of the neutron equation, my dear student. Beryllium treated with helium to form carbon. Additionally, neutrons are released. So this is the discovery of electrons and protons and neutron. Now some additional information regarding to proton and neutron. So discovery, Goldstein, and neutron discovery, Chadwick. And charge point of view, neutron there is no any charges. Neutron there is no any charges, but it's a positive charge, 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs. Actually proton charge, electron charge are similar, but sign is different. Electron negative and proton is a positive. So now this is a CGS unit, Nana. 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs. And one more value is also there, charged value, 4.8 × 10⁻¹⁰ electrostatic unit. ESU is nothing but electrostatic unit. This is the charge of the proton. So proton charge or electron charge, both of them is similar. And mass point of view, proton has mass and neutron is also mass, but here important thing is proton mass 1.673 × 10⁻²⁷ kgs, and it's expressed in the one more unit, that is called AMU, 1.00728 AMU. and neutron mass is also 1.675 × 10⁻²⁷ kgs, and 1.008665 AMU. Here important point, ma, out of the three subatomic particles neutrons are slightly more mass, and second one is a proton. So electron mass is very negligible. Okay, electron mass is very negligible. So that's why out of the three subatomic particle, protons and neutrons are present in the nucleus. That's why proton neutrons are commonly known as the nucleons. Okay, Nana, this is the information regarding to three major subatomic particle. Number one, electron. Number two, proton. Number three, neutron.